Did you know one of our favorite breakfast brands, Quaker, has a lot of food recalls? One of my favorite things to eat as a kid was Cap'n Crunch cereal. Whether I ate it straight out of the box or in a bowl with milk, it was so good. I haven't eaten any type of cereal in many years, you know, trying to be healthy. I have too much sugar. As great as my childhood memories of it are, today I'm talking about food recalls. Quaker, the owner of Cap'n Crunch cereals, granola bars, protein bars, because of salmonella concerns. What the what? While I share this information with you, and while I do that, I'm gonna prepare me something to eat. You've seen videos of me on my channel preparing and eating this same meal before. Kale, spinach, tomatoes, avocado, red leaf lettuce, and some green sauce with charred greens. Yummy! I'm hungry. I thought I'd talk about this while I whip up this meal. Let's unfold a story you might find surprising. Recent food recalls by Quaker. Gone are the days when my breakfast was Cap'n Crunch. Now it's all about these leafy greens. Where I am right now, it's about 9:30, 10 o'clock in the morning. And you don't have to wait till lunchtime. You don't have to wait until dinner. You can eat what you want when you want. Just try to make it healthy. Food recalls, as you may know, are all about keeping us safe. They're like, you know, kitchen mistakes. Sometimes things just don't go as planned. The FDA and the USDA classify these mishaps or these mistakes into three categories. Class one is serious business, like finding a stone in your salad bowl, a major health hazard. You don't want to accidentally swallow or bite down on a rock or anything like that. Class two is a little bit milder. Think of a slightly bitter tomato. Class three, that's like getting spinach when you ask for kale. It's not harmful, but it's still a mix-up. Quaker had voluntary recall of some of their oatmeal products. Why? It turns out that they had a little more than just oats and flavorings. We're talking about undeclared allergens, a big no-no in food safety. Allergens in your food can be like uninvited guests to your party. They can cause a ruckus, you know, cause some problems, especially for those with allergies. Allergens are like uninvited guests to your party. You don't want them there, you didn't expect them to be there, and they're causing all types of problems. In Quaker's case, the issue was traces of soy not listed on the label. Transparency is key. Just like in our salad, where what you see is what you get. Like what I'm making here, this looks so good, and it's gonna be so good. We know what's in here, we know what I'm putting in here. Now, sometimes, you know, your vegetables and stuff can have some issues from where they were sent or grown. But right now, I know where this came from and I'm the one that's making it, so there won't be any problems. Another recall involved a granola bar. This time, the problem was Listeria. Listeria is a bacteria that's about as welcome as our food as a fly in our soup. You know how annoying it is when you're trying to eat and flies are flying around, and every time you look away, it's sitting on your bowl, sitting on your spoon, sitting somewhere that it does not need to be. But Listeria can cause serious health problems, especially for the very young, the elderly, and those with weakened immune system. These recalls remind us of the importance of food safety. It's not just about the freshness of flavor, it's also about knowing what's in our food. That's why I love making meals like this salad. Simple, transparent, and under my control. So food recalls are not meant to scare us, but to inform us. They're part of a system that's watching out for our well-being, our safety. While we stay vigilant about what we eat, we focus on them. Start to try to be healthy. We also want to appreciate the efforts that go into keeping our food supply safe. So here's to my beautiful, tasty, yummy, safe to eat salad, a testament to healthy and mindful eating. If you found this mix of culinary delight and food safety insights helpful, don't forget to like, share, subscribe, comment, let me know what you think. Do you still eat Captain Crunch cereal? I'm not saying it's bad, but just don't eat it right now. And it's not just Captain Crunch. It's not just the Captain Crunch. It's the chewy granola bars, chocolate chip, and peanut butter chocolate chip, simply granola, or puff granola cereals, and various snack packs. All the Captain Crunch cereals, cereal bars, and oatmeal, cinnamon crunch, the berry crunch, crunch berries, crunch berry treats, peanut butter crunch treats. I'll put a link in the description and you can go check it out and see what all is an issue. They recalled it, so you probably can't find it anywhere. I was reading this article, says that of the 1.35 million Americans that salmonella hits each year, the CDC says over 26,000 get hospitalized and just over 400 die. So this is serious, you know. Everything affects everybody differently, but you don't want to be the one that it affects in the most devastating way. It's most devastating for people under 5 and over 65, because they might have possibly have compromised immune system. So the green sauce comes from one of the Mexican restaurants near me. So you can get green sauce anywhere, or you can make your own. If you have any recalled food product, don't eat it. Throw it out, return to the store for a refund, or reach out to Quaker. And the recall is all products sold in all 50 states, including Puerto Rico, Guam, and Saipan. It does not include this Quaker oats, Quaker instant oats, Quaker grits. Oh my God, I love me some grits. I wish I could have me some grits right now. Quaker oat bran, Quaker oat flour, Quaker rice snacks. There's a whole list on the QuakerRecallUSA.com. So go check it out. There are so many food recalls that I'll definitely be doing another video. Now let me enjoy my meal. The recipe is in the description if you want to know what all it is. Try it. It's tasty. And if you do, let me know what you thought about it.